Despite being released in the UK in early February 2020, Parasite remains to be one of the most talked about films of the year, raking in a gross revenue of $264.4 million and being the first Korean film to acquire the Palme d'Or award at Cannes Film Festival.
The audience are introduced to two Korean families on completely opposite ends of the economic spectrum, the Kims and the Parks. Throughout the cinematic experience, filmic elements such as mise-en-scène are used consistently throughout to present the contrast of the family's lifestyles and status, which furthermore engages with the audience, as well as bringing them to question their own morality in deciding which family they empathise and sympathise most with.
Throughout the film, Bong's subtle camera work has made an incredible impact on the way the audience views the film. With each carefully picked out shot and angle, it unravels a new layer filled with meaning for the viewer to subconsciously decode. Through the cinematography, further conflicts arise within the audience while they struggle to pick a side as the film goes on. At the start of the film, we see the Kim family portrayed in shots that use a high angle, making them, as a family, seem much smaller and weaker in comparison to the scenes that the Parks are included in, which in contrast are leveled, connoting a much more stable, balanced, and well-to-do lifestyle. Seeing this, we as an audience feel sympathy towards the Kims as we realize we are in a much higher position as we look down at them due to the high angle being used. The high angle that was being used to generally capture the Kims in quickly flips around to a low angle when Ki-woo steps into the Park's territory, immediately gaining a much higher ground, signifying the change in the storyline as well as the Kim family's fate. We are forced to look up at him due to the sudden change of angle, and the camera tracks him as he makes his way into the unfamiliar atmosphere, bringing us along with him as we travel with Ki-woo through the story space, sharing his optimism with his character as he gets a chance at a new beginning. Early on in the film, we see the camera slowly creep forward in most scenes as it is mounted on a camera dolly. This is very subtle and barely noticeable unless the first frame of the scene is compared side by side with the last frame of the chosen scene. The steady zoom allows the feeling of progression and evolution towards something much greater that lies ahead, making the spectators feel like they're a part of something while they grow closer to the characters and their journey. However, once the Kims have found their footing in this new world, the camera shots are mostly static tripod shots that are perfectly leveled, creating the balance for them that the Parks initially held. At this moment, the audience themselves feel settled and relaxed with the new pace that is introduced to them. Although, the scenes following after this point force the viewers to question the Kim family's morals and boundaries. Using Daniel Chandler's theory of the gaze, he identifies various ways in which the gaze is presented and produced in a film, and these help challenge the audience to reflect on their spectatorship. In the scene where the Kim family are all sat together, still in awe of all the obstacles that they have managed to surpass, the audience is put in the spectator's gaze. According to Chandler, this type of gaze is when the spectator is positioned in the viewpoint of the camera as they watch the character's intimate life without them knowing. When being put in this position as the viewer, they almost feel as though they are keeping a lookout for the Park family as they take in the mess unfolding before them. During the birthday party scene, the audience is yet again put in a position where they frankly seem to look for a side to pick. This chaotic scene is shot with the handheld camera, completely contrasting the previous scenes in the film where they were smooth, tripod, and gimbal-supported shots. The close-ups of both Mr. Kim and Mr. Park reveal their true nature in times of crisis, reverting back to the helplessness and vulnerability that the Kims have felt initially, in contrast to the assertive nature of Mr. Park. With this in mind, the audience tends to side more with Mr. Kim, empathizing with his lack of control in the current situation, feeling his pain as the camera focuses on his expression.
The editing of Parasite is what both credits and disrupts that which only strengthens the effectiveness and emotional impacts of its scenes. In addition, Parasite is also seamless in the way it shuffles tones, genres, moods, and its Hitchcockian likeness. D'Angelo's paper on media frames talks about how the movie places characters into perspective and makes the audience feel what the production intended them to feel about each character, but focusing on particular characters during events to expose the character's true intentions. Each cut was made to create continuity, However, even though the plot of the movie was made obvious, Jin Mo Yang and Bong Joon-ho wanted the audience to come to their own conclusion of each character. In the words of Smith, as the ultimate organizer of the text, the narration is the force that generates recognition, alignment, and allegiance, the basic components of the structure of sympathy. At the beginning of the film, the audience sympathizes with the poor family due to their lifestyle and situations they have to face, such as when the editor used a cutaway scene to join the part of the drunken stranger urinating outside the Kim's home, along with the shot of them looking helpless in the situation, when Mr. Kim and his son dragged the old housekeeper and her husband's bodies into the bunker. Jin Mo Yang stitched these shots together to create a lot of action within a single shot. Through this technique, they were able to create the exact beats and rhythms intended to further the chaotic energy. This engages the audience in a way where they feel like they're part of this event and end up wanting the Kims to get away unscathed. At the beginning of the film, when Min brings the scholar stone, the editor uses a jump cut between the shot of Ki-woo staring at the rock intently and the wide shot of Min handing over the rock to Mr. Kim. Through the use of this cut, we can see the innocence in Ki-woo's facial expression, and this could potentially lead the audience to believe that he is a character that is trustworthy. In comparison, the emotions the audience feel towards Ki-woo at this moment in time is later conflicted when there is a montage of the Kims carrying out their devious plan, and the audience question whether the Kims are as innocent as they seem and are worth sympathizing for. This evaluation of Ki-woo's character would link in with Smith's term allegiance, as the viewers make moral evaluations of the character's actions and personality.
According to Bordwell, the eye sees a lot of angles and patterns when looking around. However, it's such a remarkable part of our body that it builds a coherent world in a matter of seconds. The director uses elements such as lighting and blocking of certain actors to direct the viewer's eyes to certain areas of the screen, dominant and subsidiary contrast. Parasite uses each frame to display how the Kims eventually take over the Park household by positioning them in a way where they take up the majority of the frame when they have a new scheme or have successfully carried out their plans. It could be seen as a clever nod to Park's dialogue about crossing the line in the scene in which he was in the car with Mr. Kim. Through these subtle cues, the spectators feel themselves starting to side with the rich family as the Parks lose their sense of dominance and find themselves cornered in the frames that they share with the Kims. Another element in mise-en-scène is lighting. In the Kims' household, a greenish fluorescent light was fitted and there was a minimal use of natural lighting to portray their standard of living. On the other hand, the Parks household uses a much more natural light and luminaires to create an affluent atmosphere to show the difference between the two families. This makes the audience reflect on the state that the Kims are currently in.
In conclusion, Joon-ho's use of filmic elements such as mise-en-scène, editing, and cinematography allows the audience to develop an in-depth understanding of each character and the different dynamics and relationships they share, all the while changing their perspective towards each of them as the film progresses. This encourages the audience to really explore and develop individual relationships with each character, and this creates a conflict of emotions in the spectator's mind as they attempt to figure out which family they should really side with. It leaves them in a state of mind where they are unable to separate the good from the bad and figure out which family is actually the real parasite.